The Houseboat to Energy Efficient Residences, or HBEER project, is an example of right time, right place. The concept is to utilize Kentucky's highly skilled houseboat workforce to build affordable, modular, energy-efficient homes. HBEER is an offshoot of an experimental solar house built by the University of Kentucky College of Design, College of Agriculture, and the Center for Applied Energy Research.
In 2009, we were accepted as one of 20 schools nationally and internationally to design, build, and transport a solar decathlon house. It's about a 1,200 square foot house. The house is supposed to be off the grid, so it creates its own electricity and you design every aspect of it.
How could we take what we were developing there and do something really for some of the rural areas of Kentucky where we have real issues with low efficiency housing?
How do you turn university research created by students and faculty in collaboration among four colleges, how do you turn that into applied knowledge? Might it be possible to take that applied knowledge out and make it part of a larger project for the state?
We felt there was a real need in rural Kentucky for energy-efficient, affordable housing.
UK partnered with Kentucky Highlands Investment Corporation, a not-for-profit trying to boost economic development in southeast Kentucky. Kentucky Highlands president and CEO, Jerry Rickett, issued a challenge to UK. Design a house that can be built in a houseboat factory with 70% Kentucky-made products that costs a dollar a day to heat and cool with a purchase price of $100,000.
We became involved in this in converting and diversifying the houseboat industry and finding a new product for the houseboat industry, which of course was severely impacted with this recession. The employment in this area dropped from roughly 1,200 direct employees of houseboat manufacturers to right now somewhere around 200.
We had some very highly skilled employees that had lost their jobs. We don't want to replace the houseboat industry. We wanted to help it survive and grow and make infill products that we could produce in the same factories and do it when they don't have orders for houseboats, and hopefully help bring some of the plants back.
And so looking at for the future, what could they do? That was where the idea of using those same facilities, the same workforce to make high-efficient housing really made sense.
The 1,000-square-foot prototype was constructed at Stardust Cruisers in two 11-feet-wide sections. Then, the two-bedroom, one-bath house was trucked to its site just a few miles away in Monticello, Kentucky.
One of our goals was to help the houseboat industry supply chain and others in the supply chain if we could.
If you get 80 to 90% of the providers or producing the component pieces in the state of Kentucky, then we can support tin presses and cabinetry people and all kinds of small businesses.
We got about 82% of the cost in this particular unit was spent with Kentucky manufacturers or individuals within the state. They provided a service or something to us. You know, we bought as much locally as we could to avoid freight cost and be as energy efficient as we could.
Thanks to energy-efficient building techniques and appliances, this house will use 40% less water and 50% less electricity than a standard house.
Being able to control what you spend every month on energy is a much better approach for making affordable housing. It's not just the house being affordable, but the energy consumption being affordable.
By lowering the cost of the energy, we'll be able to help more families get into an affordable house.
We're hoping that by creating housing that is efficient, we boost that affordability by making it easier to live in, more cost effective to live in, easier to maintain, something that can be afforded for the long haul.
We're going to ask the family that purchases the home to share their utility costs with us. And then we'll take that information and use it as we design additional units.
What began as an idea in the minds of UK design students has evolved into two prototype homes.
I think the most important part of the studio was grounding your design work in practicality. So when you come up with an idea of how you can save energy, it wasn't just, okay, that sounds like a great idea. It was, well, let's make it work and let's make it work on a budget.
It's fun to see students who have been turned loose and given a challenge and have expansive ideas about what can be done only limited by what's physically possible and what code will allow and what will continue to stand up.
It's important for the students to actually engage in a project both intellectually and practically. In other words, they've been able to do a lot of research into different methods of prefabrication over time, but also think of new ways of being able to fabricate a home off-site.
There's nothing like actually putting the puzzle together to find out what's missing and what would have worked better if it had been in a different place. So.
You create a prototype of a design, and then you refine it, and you create another, and you refine it. And what the students are beginning to understand and to see and to learn is that that prototyping process itself is the way in which innovation occurs.
Thanks to federal, state, and local funding, the scope of HBEER has expanded from single-family homes to multifamily homes, classrooms, clinics, and commercial buildings.
The idea of building modular and taking to a site has almost limitless possibilities because you're doing the same work that you would do on site.
People are living in these houses and the economy and the environment are benefiting from the modular process.
This project came along in a moment when the faculty were ready for it and the students were ready for that type of engagement where, you know, the lives of the people who inhabit their buildings would be changed for what they perceive to be the better.
I grew up about four doors down from here. It's good to come back to your neighborhood and hopefully have a positive impact and replace an old structure with something that can be a model and a predecessor for a lot of other housing units that can help low-income families.